Hello again YouTube, Enzo back bringing you another video, and today we're going to be continuing a look at Transformers, Titans Returns, Galvatron and all the modifications I've done thus far. So as you can see, I have removed the cockpit, so jet mode is no longer available, and I've also taken this part that fits the headmaster from the cannon as well, because obviously we don't need that, which limits posability. So you can see he's got a bit, he's able to move his cannon a bit more. And obviously I put the attachment on the back there as well, so you can see he looks so much better. And I've also taken the liberty of painting the treads today, like a darkish grey. So there we go. That's all I can do on my own, because at the moment, as promised, Shapeways has arrived. I do apologise upside down because it's got all my information at the bottom, and sorry, you're not having that. So there we go. So there's the famous bubble wrap. Now, as I said, there are three items that I've ordered. So obviously the first is the G1 head sculpt, or the G1 helmet I should say. There is that. There is the adapter for the cannon, for the cannon to fit on the side. And what a lot of people have been asking me for is, there we go, here's the baby. This was on Shapeways as well, and as you can see, it is a perfect representation of his G1 blaster. Absolutely fantastic. And there's a lot of weight to this. I had it done in the orange, because obviously the barrel is mostly orange, so I didn't want to paint it. And I've just had a quick look at a few of the, because you can see all the, so if I can zoom, so if you can get a good look at all the lovely detail in here, a lot of it has been brought out. You go on Google and you search Transformers Galvatron gun in there, and you will see this cannon come up there. So all the moulding, oh, it just looks absolutely fantastic. Very, very nice. I have already plugged this in, so I know it fits. In fact, let's do it right now. So the only problem with this is it's one piece. It doesn't have a peg on the back, so you can't put it into cannon mode, but it doesn't matter. Obviously, you've seen the pictures. So this will be used for cannon mode, space cannon mode, and this will be used for robot mode. So there we go. So just a quick little tease now. Let's just plug that in there. And that just looks so much better. He's able to wield that a lot better. And obviously with that, with the adapter in now, obviously on the side there like that, that should be able to fit. Because what I'm tempted to do, and I don't know if I'm going to do it, I'm really, really tempted to make a little hole down there and actually plug it into his forearm, because that's where it should be on most of the cartoons and things like that. It's not up here, it's down here. And I'm thinking it would be better maybe if I just put a little tiny hole there and plugged it in like that. What do you think? That's what I'm thinking at the time being. Might make the can a little bit longer, but I think that'll be a good thing. And yes, it does fit in his hand as well, so if you want him, you can have him holding his cannon like that. It's entirely up to you. But yeah, there's a couple little things and a couple of tweaks I'm going to do to it now. I don't know if it's showing up on camera, but there's a bit of a grain going there. You can see where it's been sanded down, so I'm going to get some really thin or fine sandpaper, I should say. I'm going to sand all this down, get it really nice and flush as I can. And anyway, quick tip now, if anybody has ordered Shapeways stuff before, you'll know the second you get these now, before you do any painting at all, you put them in lukewarm water, lukewarm soapy water I should say, get an old toothbrush or something soft and give them a damn good scrub, because you can see there's a bit of residue in there from the manufacturing process. That's quite hollow as well, but you can see there's a bit of debris in there, so that needs to come out. That needs to come out as well, left over. So yeah, and obviously if you paint it then and you haven't cleaned it thoroughly and dried it thoroughly, it's going to really mess up your paint. That's a lesson I learned when I did my Optimus Prime B-Center's Gatling gun. So I won't be making that mistake again. And basically all I'm going to do is, all this is going to be silver, including these little bits here. This little bit is going to be grey, I'm going to try, and then some black ink or black markers in there then follow the grooves just to make the cannon stand out a little bit more. Try and get it to look as G1-ish as possible. So there we go. I know a lot of people have been asking about this, and don't worry, I haven't forgotten you. I will be putting, when I come to do my next video, I'll put everything up. I'll do all the links, so you can go to Shapeways and you can buy your own. So there is that, and I've been looking forward to this. This is the G1 head sculpt, or the G1 helmet, I should say. And let me just try and zoom in there, because this is really super detailed. This looks really, really nice. If my camera will play ball, there we go. Look at all that, lovely, lovely. You can see through the camera, I can see it all sparkling. That's why you do, that's just residue left over from the 3D process. So you do have to give these a damn good scrub. So don't worry about that. You can see all the lovely, lovely details over there. I mean, this gentleman, Fake Busker 83, he really knows his stuff. I bought a few things from him in the past, and he just continues to impress all the time. Little notch there for the headmaster. So let's have a go then. Let's just flip that down, get rid of that, put him in, and plonk him on with his new cranium, and there we go. I've also painted his chin black as well, so hopefully he'll stand out a bit better. Let's zoom in there for you. So obviously looking at, actually looking through the camera with the light on, it's a little bit lighter. You might be able to see it a bit differently than I can, but that is basically G1 Galvatron. He looks cool, really, really cool. I know the best thing is you've got the full poseability of that ball joint. The helmet is snug. It's not super tight, but it fits over the headmaster thusly, and it is a nice, snug, secure fit. I've seen a lot of other videos where other reviewers have said that they were given test shots to see if everything worked out fine, and a lot of people said that they were a bit wobbly, things like that, but that is nice and secure. Nice and secure. Brilliant. So there is that. And the last bit of the Shapeways puzzle is obviously the adapter for the arm. So let me just get that out. Again, a really nice, out of focus there. Sorry about that. A really nice detailed piece there. Still a bit sparkly. Just a bit of residue. So obviously it needs to go into the, needs to be washed and scrubbed. And basically all you were going to do then is just plug that into the gap in the forearm. This is quite tight, I'm finding it at the moment. I don't know whether Fake Busker has tweaked it in any way, shape or form, but it is, actually, it's not going in as snugly as I thought. It might even be a little too big, and I don't want to push it or force it. Actually, it's not going in at all. That's a bit of a disappointment. So well, basically what you see in here is trial and error. So I might be a little bit extra to shave off there now. So I'll just, I don't want to force it because I don't want to break it. So I might have to sand that down a little bit just to make it fit. But I'm a bit disappointed that I was hoping it was going to go in. But I did take the liberty of trying it out first of all. And obviously that does fit in there very, very easily. So you can imagine now with that painted up and that like that, that does not look so much better. He's got all the possibility then. He can aim the cannon any way he wants. So, what should I do? I mean, I could either plug it in down here, or I can leave it up there. In fact, I think what I'll do is I'll leave it up there for the time being. I won't bother drilling any holes in his forearms. I think I'll leave it, even though it wouldn't take much, because obviously in there it's completely empty. So, but it could be a hole there. I'm thinking about it. I really am thinking about it. But Oop, buddies. So there we go. So I'm a bit disappointed about that, which is a shame. And just in case you were wondering, then obviously yes, that does fit there as well. So I could use the original can in there. Looking at it now, it does look a bit silly. So I'm glad I did buy that other cannon. So let's put him back in there now. There we go, that doesn't look so bad. And that helmet, just sets him off. I mean, I really am satisfied with my purchase from Shapeways. So for this cannon, the helmet and the adapter, I think I paid less than 30 British pounds sterling, to be honest with you. I think it was like 40 something euros together, because obviously I thought Shapeways came from America. No, apparently it's shipped from the Netherlands. So, and it only took, I think about a week, 7 days for everything to arrive. And just look at the craftsmanship there. I mean, I know it's not done by hand, it's the 3D printing process, but the pictures that I've seen now, this gentleman has really nailed this cannon spot on. I did message him beforehand to say, does this fit Titan Master's Galvatron? But I didn't get an answer, so I just thought, Dad, you know what, I'm just going to go with it. And yeah, it looks good. Looks really, really good. So I can't recommend these two gentlemen enough. I can't recommend Shapeways enough, because they've got products for absolutely everything on there. So there we are, that's my little teaser boxy video. So please stick around now, and what I'm going to do next is I will clean and paint both items, both the helmet, the gun, and the adapter. I'm disappointed it doesn't fit. I mean, I suppose I could really force it in, because obviously once it's in, it's in. I suppose I really could try that, but I'll try that off camera just in case I break it. But we'll give it a go. And if any of you think, like, you know, I should drill a hole in the forearm to have the cannon fit in like that, like in the G1, then you know, if I get enough likes, or if I get enough people commenting on it, then yeah, I might just do that. I think, oh, you got me thinking now. The more I think about it, the more I want to do it. So yeah, we'll take it from there. But yeah, there is Titan 32 and Galvatron with all the Shapeways accessories. And I think if you really want a G1 looking Galvatron, and you don't want to spend on third party and things like that, get yourself a Titan Master Galvatron. Go to Shapeways, get the gun, the adapter, and the helmet. Do the little mod like I've done. Get rid of this stupid jet mod and shorten the cannon. Or go to Shapeways and buy something like that, and you will end up with something that looks absolutely brilliant. So, hope you've enjoyed my little video, and stay tuned, and I'll come back to you once all the painting has been done. Okay, diolch yn fawr. Thank you very much. Ta-ra.